and family time, a new book by an author known for a popular children's series has just been released. And it's written and illustrated by a mother-son team that have roots right here in Rhode Island. And get this, we are related. Very cool. Joining us here in studio this morning is author and my aunt, Janet Tajin, along with illustrator and her son, my cousin, Jake. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's great to be here.
It all comes back around, right?
Love it.
Happy to have you here. Catch us up on your My Life As a series.
Well, the My Life As a Book series started because I've been doing school visits for like 20 years, mm-hmm. and teachers and librarians were always looking for ways to reach reluctant readers. So I wrote My Life As a Book and My Life As a Stunt Boy and Cartoonist and soon My Life As a Joke for a way to reach those kids that had a hard time reading and mm-hmm. were visual learners. And Jake did the illustration, so it was very fun to collaborate together.
I think that's so cool, Jake. How many illustrations are in each book?
Well, over 250.
Over 250. And what is the process? How do you come up with making these drawings?
So I get the manuscript, and I go through it, mm-hmm. and I figure out like what word to use, and then I look up what that word is, mm-hmm. and then I draw it, then our editor gives us feedback, and then I do another version, mm-hmm. and I ink it.
He's been doing drawing his vocabulary words since elementary school, mm-hmm. and we have boxes of them all over the house, and people would always really think they were hilarious, and they are. The kids all around the world have really responded to the drawings, which is great.
Yeah, and there's plenty of drawings in your latest book. It just came out. Rave reviews. Tell us about it.
Well, it's Einstein the Class Hamster, and he's from a long line of class hamsters, mm-hmm. so he really is the smartest student in the class. Unfortunately, no one can hear him besides one kid. And he's kind of obsessed with game shows and fun facts and trivia. For example, did you know who the first person was to bring pasta to the United States?
I have no clue.
Thomas Jefferson.
Fun facts. We like fun facts.
We do. And when I was a kid, those were the kind of things that I loved. It's mm-hmm. like little tidbits of information. Yep. So the book is full of them. And Jake did an amazing job with the illustrations.
Jake, Einstein, though, has been around for a while, longer than this book, right?
Yeah, it has. Well, in middle school, I decided to do a daily comic strip that actually stars a class hamster. When I showed them to my mom, she thought it was extremely hilarious, and we both thought it would transfer well into a book. But it was kind of like a challenge to me because mm-hmm. I had to focus on a lot of character design. Yeah, I had to focus on the character design of the kids, the turtle, mm-hmm. the principal, everyone.
They're all found in this book, which I just think is so great. What age range are these books for?
Well, like 7 to 9 kind of age. And if people go to EinsteinTheClassHamster.com, mm-hmm. the first chapter of the book is there, and there's interactive games and a trailer that Jake made that's hilarious. So there's a lot of fun stuff.
And First Book is such a great organization, too, that's working with Einstein.
Yes,
right?
First Book is a national nonprofit, and they are signing up schools. Teachers can go there, sign up their school. They've got 1,000 copies of Einstein that they are, you know, giving to Title I schools. So mm-hmm. people should definitely go to that website, too, and sign up.
All right, a lot of kids in need. We will have to do that. Thank you both for coming in.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. If you want to learn more about Janet's series, we'll post the information on our website. It's the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com. And there it is right there. You can pick up your copy of Einstein the Class Hamster, available now.